Next, we have Rishab. Rishab is a software engineer at Social Cops and works as a data parser, focusing on scraping data from open data sets. You will speak about highlighting the best location for LPG gas centers and why is it so important for a country like India.
So guys, over the past couple of days, we've seen a lot of examples, heard a lot about what can happen if you marry GIS with public data and take it to the decision makers. So through this presentation, I'm going to show you some of the examples of what happened when we took these maps and brought these decisions to actual decision makers and how today they can make much more efficient planning decisions and use the data much more effectively. So one of the first things that we did was we worked with Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and helped them plan the next 10,000 LPG centers in the country. Now, why are LPG centers important? Because people who don't have LPG centers use firewood or chulha. Cooking on a chulha is equivalent to smoking 400 cigarettes a day. So that's why we really needed to reach these people, and that's what the mission of the entire project was, to reach 50 million BPL women in rural areas and get them access to LPG. So how we did it? Yeah, so before we actually came in, this was how the ministry was working on it. They were actually drawing maps on paper and marking areas, and they were just based on intuition, based on very little data, were marking, okay, this is one place where we can open a center. They didn't have correct data of where their current centers are and where they should actually go to reach these people. And what we finally replaced this with is an actual algorithm that calculated what are these areas where people don't have access. We balance variables like access to roads, because wherever these centers will be opened, we'll need roads for taking the goods to these centers. These people will need access to markets. So if there's a market, that location was prioritized because people already visit that place. If there was a mandi, if there was railway stations, if it had the right kind of population who needs access to these, who needs access to LPG, we mapped all of those things. And we finally came up with the exact villages that needed LPG centers and what are the best locations for these exact centers. And so today, out of the 10,000 centers that we recommended to the government, more than 6,000 have already been opened. Rest 30% have been commissioned and are in the process of opening, and the rest 10% have already been advertised. So this is actually a map of a woman in village Gurundia in district Sundargarh. The same woman who was earlier using firewood now today has a connection to LPG and doesn't have to use firewood. So through this we learned that people don't really understand geospatial data. People don't think in geospatial ways, which can make their decision making process much better, much faster, and much more efficient. We did similar exercises in Madhya Pradesh. So LPG center exercise we did across the country. We did similar things for rural vaccination programs, where we helped the government identify the regions where their distribution network was failing and how they can redistribute and make the process more efficient, and wherever needed, open better centers. And what are the exact locations for these centers? Now, the issues with data are, there are some things that can never be captured. So for example, you would recommend a location, but then the people would go on ground and realize that that place does not have electricity. And that was not really captured in the data. So we made this a simulation exercise where people could actually see on a map what are the locations that we are recommending, go on ground, verify those, and if it doesn't work for them for any reason, they could choose a nearby location and the whole redistribution plan. And the algorithm will run again and redistribute the entire network to reach a more efficient model of how you can place those exact centers and how you can optimize your supply chain. Now moving on from government, the other example is Unilever, one of the biggest FMCGs in the country, which has 15 lakh stores And today, they don't really understand where people are and where they have the maximum sales potential in a geospatial way. So we actually created a hierarchical grid system which told them at a 1 kilometer grid level exactly how many people live in this region and what are the demographics of these people. And through these variables, we could map sales potential for them. Okay, my time is over. I'll just take 2 more minutes and finish this. And yeah, through this, we could really map what's the sales potential in different regions for different kinds of products. Because there are products like Lifebuoy, which can help them stop malaria, and various other products that are really needed in the rural regions as well. So what we finally learned was that if you give the right data to the right people and give them the power, they can use the geospatial data that is collected today, but not leverage the right way. So what we want to come up with, what me and my team are currently working on, is a very easy to use geospatial product that makes this data accessible, usable, and much more interactive. Because other than the people in this room, there are very few people in that entire country who really understand this data. And we really need to make it more accessible, because spatial is not special. It's just like any other data set, and people should have access to it. And think it can disrupt everything from government to logistics, to retail, to finance, to pharma, and all of these other sectors. So I'd love to talk to each one of you later and understand what are some of the problems that you have faced while analyzing geospatial data, how we can help, what are the features that we should prioritize for you if you need them. And I'd like to end the presentation with a famous quote that everything in the world happens somewhere, and that is why we really need geospatial data. Thank you.